Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the webinar on discovering opportunities to study in France, which Indo-French Chamber of Commerce and Industry is organizing with an association with Joinin Campus. Joinin Campus Education Private Limited is a world-leading edtech company specializing in higher education for France and Europe, along with countries like Canada, US, UK, Australia, New Zealand, and across the globe. Our speakers will share details on why you should choose France as your destination for your further studies, information on top universities of France, admission process, etc. I would like to welcome our speakers, Ms. Avni Trivedi Sevak, Branch Manager with Joinin Campus, and Sapna Verma, Head of HR and Recruitment, Indo-French Chamber of Commerce. Welcome again to our speakers, and over to you, Avni and Sapna.
Thank you, Neha. Thank you so much. So, good afternoon, everyone, and I welcome all of you to our today's session on discovering opportunities to study in France. So, let me just share my screen. I hope my screen is visible to all of you.
Yes, Avni.
Okay, thank you. Yes. So before we start, let me just give you a brief introduction about Joinin Campus. Yes, Neha already has given a brief introduction. I would just like to add a few points. We are into this industry since 2008. So it's been 12 years now. We are promoting French education and services in France. As you can see, like, we have our registered offices in France, in India, in USA, Singapore, Turkey, and Canada. We are a member of few organizations like NAFSA, ICEF, EAIE, WEBA, and UniAgents. As I said, like, it's been now 12 years, so we have been promoting French education and, of course, other European countries as well since last 5 to 6 years. We have been promoting 200 plus top-ranked universities in Europe, of which we have tied up with 100 plus universities of France and 130 plus universities across Europe. Now, why study in France? Our today's main topic of discussion is this, like, why students, they should choose France as their overseas destination. What are the benefits that students they are getting while choosing France as their overseas destination? So we will be discussing, like, there are n number of benefits students they are getting while choosing France as their overseas destination. But before going to that, I will just give you a brief introduction about France. Like, it is located in the heart of the European Union. It has a modern and dynamic European country. It is well known for world economic power. Of course, this is a very good point. Like, France, it's the world's fourth leading host country for higher education. Like, France is the fourth country who is welcoming maximum number of international students for their higher studies. And they have also set a goal of welcoming around 5 lakh students by 2027. It is well known for its grand ecosystem of education and business. Now, let's come to this, like, what are the benefits students they are getting while they are choosing France compared to other countries? So the very first benefit is, like, France, it is well known for its quality education. Now, when I say it is well known for its quality education, I don't mean to say, like, other countries, they don't have quality education. Of course, we have quality education in India as well. But France, when I say it is well known for its quality education, means, like, there is a system, they are having, you know, internships along with the studies. So students, they are getting practical knowledge along with the theoretical knowledge. And these are some accreditations, like most of the programs and most of the universities, they are having these accreditations. So quality is the main point that is focused in France. And of course, students, when they choose France, they get a quality education. Secondly, the tuition fees in France, it is very, very affordable compared to other countries. You can see, like, bachelor's, it starts from around 6,300 approximately per year, and master's, it is approximately 7,300 euros per year. So the tuition fees are very affordable, and of course, compared to the countries like US, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, this tuition fees is very, very affordable. And in Europe as well, we have affordable tuition fees. Most of the programs that France is offering and most of the programs that are offered by our partner universities, we don't require any entrance exam or any English exams like IELTS, GRE, GMAT, nothing. Of course, a few of the programs and few of the universities and schools, there is a requirement. But in majority of the schools and universities, IELTS or GRE, GMAT is not required. Yes, you can see like there is a condition to this, and the main condition is your education throughout should be in English. That is, your medium of instruction should be English. Then and then only this requirement is not there. Or else, of course, you have to give an IELTS exam. Maybe if you are going for an MBA program, GMAT is required. But for majority of the schools, it is not required. So this is a very, very plus point. Yes, your level of English, your motivation, everything will be checked by the school before you are given an admission. So there will be a Skype interview, and you need to clear that interview in order to get admitted to a particular school or university. But this is the first requirement. Like if your medium of instruction is English, then it is not at all required. This is what I was discussing, like, you know, it is well known for its quality of education. There are paid internship opportunities with multinational companies. So let me just explain you in detail, like how it works. So whatever program a student is going for, or whatever program a student is enrolling for, whether it is a bachelor's program or whether it is a master program, in France, we have very well paid internship opportunities, and with multinational companies, of course, with other companies as well. So it will be like internships will be of minimum 4 to 6 months, but depending on the company, it can be of 1 year, it can be even more than that. Minimum requirement is 4 to 6 months. So every program, every school, the internship part is a part of your program. If you are not going for an internship, of course, you have to write the thesis, and then only you can complete your degree. You are able to get the degree. So either you go for thesis or you go for internships. And I would like to say, like, you know, 99% of the students, they are going with the internship, and it's a very good experience. Like, students, they learn how to work in the industry, and they get practical knowledge along with the theoretical knowledge. So this is a very good part. Of course, few other countries, they do have internships along with their studies. It is also a part of their curriculum. But in France, I would like to mention, like, they have paid internships. So internships, they are paid, and not only paid, they are very well paid. I would like to add that. So students, they have a very good opportunities while they enroll for any master's or bachelor programs in France. Here you can see there are a few well-known multinational companies in which our students, they are already doing their internships or who have already done their internships. So these are a few multinational companies where students, they did their internships, and they were very well paid during their internships. Of course, by law, there are minimum you know, wages what are given during their internships. But then again, everything depends on company and depends on student, like how capable student is, and then you can earn good. Another benefit that students they are having is cost of living. Cost of living in France is less compared to other countries. So it is also very affordable, and of course, there are many benefits given by government as well, which brings cost of living to lower in for international students. The very first benefit that students they are getting is in accommodation. Government, they are giving a subsidy, which is known as CAF, C-A-F, which is 30 to 40% that students they are getting, and this brings their cost of accommodation lower. In this, like, all international students, they are getting this benefit, and in this, the 30% or 40% of the rent will be paid by government, and rest students they have to pay. So this is the first thing that brings your cost of living down. accommodation is somewhat very important, and of course it will be lowered by 30% because you are getting subsidy in France. And as I mentioned, like all international students, they will be getting this benefit. Apart from that, there is a low transportation cost as well. Like student, they are having a transportation card, so you know, they have student discounts, and which brings again transportation costs to lower compared for other you know, visitors or other citizens. So this also lowers your cost of living. And as I said, like students, they have a student card, so they have special discounts everywhere, in cafes, in malls, in theaters. So for students, really the cost of living is low compared to other countries. And of course, as I mentioned, like government, they are doing their best to give this benefits to all international students. We always, you know, have a question like, when we are choosing France, is French mandatory? Are we required to learn French, and what all it is about? So there are two ways, I will say, like, you know, as you can see, learn French while in France, or of course you can learn French from India as well. So suppose if you are planning to apply for spring intake, which will be either in Jan or March, or if you are planning to apply for fall intake in September, so you know, you have an ample of time. And always what we say to our students, that please do have a basic knowledge of French. And of course, it is not at all mandatory, because whatever programs you are taught, they are 100% in English, and it is, French language is not required over there. But what we say, like French as a second language, as a second foreign language, you should be always having the basic knowledge. So now when you are targeting spring or fall intake, as I said, you have ample of time. So what you can do is you can learn basic French, at least one level of French from Alliance Francaise over here. And suppose if you don't have time, then the another option is like you can learn French when you are there in France. So how come it will be possible? So when you are in France, again, there are two options for learning French language. The very first option is like, you know, the school in which you have enrolled for, the school where you are going for your higher studies. Each and every school, they are having French as a subject. Like they will be teaching you basic French along with your main subjects. So what we advise our students, please don't miss these classes. Attend these classes, so by the time you will be finishing off your degrees, you will be at least having the basic knowledge of French. Apart from that, again, government over here, they have set up organization where student, they can go and enroll themselves for one-time enrollment fee, and then they can learn French over there for as many hours they want, as many levels they want. So this is how you can learn French when you are in France. But make sure you have basic knowledge of French. The best example what I always used to give to our students is like, you know, currently I am based in Gujarat, in Ahmedabad. And even if in India I am traveling to other cities, like if I am traveling to Mumbai or I am traveling to Chennai or Bangalore, though I know English, but if I am knowing the local language, it is always in my benefit. So whenever you are going to France, and if you are having basic knowledge of French, always you will be benefited. So please do focus on French language and learn French from India if you have enough time. If not, when you are in France, please attend the classes that are organized by your schools or universities. Or else you can also learn French while enrolling in one of the government organizations. So once again, I will say it is not mandatory, but it is very useful and it is in your benefit if you will learn French. Part-time jobs. Students, they always have a question regarding this, like, you know, whether we will be allowed to do part-time jobs, and what are the hours that we can work? What are the wages that we'll be getting during our part-time jobs? So of course, like any other countries, in France as well, you are allowed to do part-time jobs, and that is 20 hours per week. Mainly students, they do part-time jobs in food joints or in cafes or like that, or maybe of delivering the couriers and like this. So of course you can work part-time, and somewhere over here, what we were discussing regarding the language, So if you know the language and if you have basic knowledge about that, it will really help you for your part-time jobs also. European Union visa, this is again a very good benefit that all students they are getting. If you are going to France and if you have your visa for France, you also on completing the formalities once you land in France, you will be getting European Union visa, which means like you can travel to any of the European Union countries. Of course, I will mention here, like, you know, you can't go and settle over there. You can go for your holidays and then you can come back to France, finish off your studies. And then, you know, if you are getting your internships or jobs in any of these countries, of course, you can go and do the jobs and internships. So I will mention over here one point also, like, you know, for internships, you can do internship in any part of the world where you want. And if you are getting internships in, you know, the company located in US, you can go and do your internship in US. If you are getting internship in Germany, in Switzerland, you can go and do your internships in Germany, Switzerland as well. Of course, some of our students, they do come back to India and they do internships in the French companies which are located over here. So what does this indicates? Like, whatever programs you are studying in, whatever degrees you are enrolled for, it has its impact and it is valid worldwide. Okay, so this is also a very good point for all of you. Like, it is open all over the world, wherever you want to do your internships. And yes, this is the benefit. Like, if you are getting internships in any of the European Union countries, you need not to apply for visa. You can directly go and do your internships over there. And of course, after internships, if you are getting permanent jobs, you can settle over there as well. So this is a very good benefit. Like, you get visas for all 26 European countries if you are getting visa for France. 2 years of post study visa. So this is applicable for most of the courses, but not for all of the courses. Students, you have 2 years of post study visa once you finish off your studies. And you know, it is also known as jobs visas. Like, you know, once you finish off the studies, you can search for your job and you are allowed to stay in France for 2 more years. And but yes, of course, in these 2 years, you have to find a job for yourself related to your field of studies, and then you can apply for your you know, job visa. But yes, this is a very good benefit compared to other countries. Few countries, they do have 2 years post study, like London they are having, and of course, as I said, like France, they do have 2 years. But yes, you need to check like whether your programs they are certified, RNCP certified. If it is RNCP certified, you will be getting 2 years of post study visa, and you will be allowed to study, you will be allowed to stay in France once you finish off your studies and internships. After that, 2 years are given to you. So this is again a very good benefit that students they are getting while choosing France as their overseas destination. Again, scholarships, you have ample scholarships available. Like, there are government scholarships, and there are also scholarships offered by schools and universities. Government scholarships, of course, it is somewhat you have to plan early and you have to apply for, because the deadlines are very soon. And we have like Chapak scholarship, we have Eiffel scholarship, and many more scholarships that are offered by government, and they have different benefits. We do have scholarships that are given by schools and universities, and in that mainly we are having merit-based scholarships, we are having early bird scholarships. So, you know, if you are interested, and if your resume is up to the mark, like if it is fitting the criteria of the scholarships offered by universities or government, of course, you will be eligible to get that. And there are many other scholarships as well. So again, if you are getting scholarships, it will bring down your tuition fees. So you can apply for scholarships and you can avail this benefit as well. Opportunities for PR. This is again, you know, a very common question that is always asked by the students, like whether there are any opportunities of PR or not. Of course, I will say like you do have opportunities for PR in France, but there are certain criteria and there are certain conditions that you have to meet with before you apply for your PR or before you apply for your citizenship. So the very first criteria is that you need to be in France for 5 continuous years. You have to stay in France for 5 years, and then only you are eligible to apply for PR. Of course, apart from that, there are many other conditions that you need to take care of, like it will be your job prospects, it will be your salary prospects, it will be your financial statements and everything. But yes, the very main condition that you are eligible to apply or not is your stay in France. So you should be in France for 5 continuous years, then and then only you are eligible to apply for PR. But of course, you have opportunities for PR and you can apply for that. Coming to the next slide, Paris, it is ranked as the best student city in top 10 for 5 years continuously. And of course, it was ranked as number one for 2 consecutive years in 2015 and 2016. And then it dropped down to number 2, number 5, and number 7. Still, we are waiting for the results of 2020. But yes, Paris, it is still ranked in top 10 for the best student cities. And it is ranked on different criteria. Coming to the schools, like as I said, we are promoting 100 plus top ranked French universities, and most of the schools that we are promoting, they are triple accredited schools. And let me just tell you, very few schools, they are triple accredited, and only 1.5% business schools, they are triple accredited. Few of which over here, they are, I have mentioned, like Rain School of Business, Neoma Business School, Cash Business School, Toulouse Business School, Montpellier, Paris Business School, they are all triple accredited, and they are among this 1.5% business schools they are triple who are triple accredited. Other schools that we are mainly promoting are EPITA Graduate School of Engineering, ISEP, again, it's an engineering school. IMT Atlantic, it's an engineering school. Apart from that, Subbiotech, we have an agricultural program in that. We do have UCO, which is well known for its MBA program, ESCA and Schema Business School. Schema Business School, it has more than 20 MSc programs and of course bachelor programs with 3 campuses in France itself. There are a few more schools like ICAR, it is well known for film and television and it is in Paris itself. Then we do have Le Cordon Bleu and Vatel, which are very well known for hotel and tourism management programs. Of course, we have fashion management programs with Modart and many other schools. So this was a glimpse of few management and engineering schools that we represent in France, and they are all very good accredited. And from the schools, I will say like majority of the schools, their programs are RNCP certified, which means like you will be eligible for 2 years of stay back once you finish off your studies. Intakes, so mainly we have 2 intakes in France. Fall intake is our main intake. It's a major intake, which almost all the schools they are having. And it is usually the programs they are starting in September or October. Apart from that, we do have a spring intake, which is January to May. Like a few schools, they have programs starting in January. Few of them, they have programs starting in March and even in May. Spring is not that major intake like fall, because we don't have all the schools who are offering the spring intake, but yes, like 50% of the schools, they do offer spring intake. Application checklist, like what you require, what are the documents you require when you are applying for your higher studies to one of the schools in France. So it is a very general application checklist, which is required by almost all the countries, and I will quickly go through the application checklist. We require your copy of passport first and last page, your updated resume, your academic documents 10th onwards, in which we require mark sheets and transcripts as well. Of course, your last obtained degree certificates, 2 letters of recommendation. Now, letters of recommendation, it is not mandatory for all the schools. Some schools, they require 1, some they require 2. So two letters of recommendation, statement of purpose, like your motivation letter, why you want to go to France, and why you have selected a particular school, and why a particular program. So just to note, like, how motivated you are to study in France and in a particular school or program. We require your passport size photograph for the applications, duly filled application form if it is offline application, or maybe if it is online application, then it's fine. Your experience letters, if any, like if you have any work experience, we do require your experience letter. This document checklist, it may vary on the requirement of different schools and universities, but yes, as I mentioned, it is a very general checklist, and hardly one or two more documents might be required by other universities or schools. Now, what is the process, like how it works? If you are interested to study in France, what is the very first thing you need to do? So the very first thing is you need to finalize the university and program which you want to apply for. Once you are done with the finalization of the university and program, the second step is to arrange all your documents as per the checklist, what I mentioned earlier. And once you're ready with all the documents, the step three comes is online application. If it is an online application, then you have to do online application. If it is paper-based application, then of course you need to fill out the paper form. If it is an online application, need not to worry, because everything is taken care by Join in Campus. We at Join in Campus make sure, like, you know, we assist you in each and every step of your study abroad dream. So we will be filling your online application, and of course with your consent, and we will be cross verifying all the details before we submit it to the university or school. Then comes, like, once you verify that your form is okay, we submit the applications along with all your documents to the school, and you have to pay application fees, if any. Again, I will say, like, you know, if you are applying through Join in Campus, in most of the schools and universities, application fees are being waived off. So if you go through Join in Campus, it will be waived off in majority of the schools. Because as I said, like, we are with the school since last 12 years promoting the schools. So for our students, they have waived off the application fees. Once your application is submitted, after being reviewed, you know, within, I will say 5 to 7 working days, or maybe within 3 to 4 working days for few schools and universities, you will be getting an intimation for your Skype interview. So as I mentioned earlier in my presentation, like, you know, you will have to face a Skype interview. You will have to prove your motivation to study in that school, why you are interested and all. And your level of English will also be checked during this interview. So there will be a Skype interview with the program manager of the particular program in which you have applied. And you need to crack this interview. So once you crack this interview, and then you are accepted. So, and again, within 7 to 8 working days, we will be getting an intimation which we will be giving you that, okay, you have been accepted. And then you will be getting your conditional offer letter. Conditional offer letter with the condition to pay, you know, certain amount of fees. Maybe it might be 30% or 50%, depending on.
Yeah, hi everyone. So Avni will just join us in a while, and I'm going to discuss with you all also the next important question which comes up, that, you know, once you have a degree, you know, you've studied in France, and what are the employment opportunities that are actually available to, you know, you students over here. So, you know, the Indo-French Chamber is actually the one where, you know, the chamber where we are actually not only assisting companies to, you know, get talent, but we are also you know assisting the alumni who are actually, you know, been studying in France, learning the French language, you know, to actually get a job. So just to kind of give you a little input on the French Chamber of Commerce, the Chamber of Commerce was established several years ago, and we are a chamber of an association of companies which has actually been created to promote economic and trade relations between India and France. So the idea in the chamber is actually to bring through together a network of people. So we have about 650 member companies, and the companies engage with each other. You know, they're able to share best practices. They're able to use our services to, you know, take things forward in terms of business engagement, business development, setting up companies in India. So I think this is the introduction which I'm sharing. Bhakti, you can move on to the next slide. So our core services, we do a lot of advocacy. We have events, business support services, the HR and recruitment services, which would be of interest to y'all. So I think we can suggest to all students that, you know, and others, when you have studied French or you've gone to France, or even if you have not, please feel free to, free to share your CV with us. And we'd be more than happy to register it in our database and, you know, give you that opportunity to engage with French and Indian companies when there is an opportunity. Bhakti, you can change the slide. So we have a database of 4,000 profiles. Our service was created in 2012, and it's been 8 years, and we've been really able to create a very strong base, and we've done about 400 placements since 2012. Yes, Bhakti, next. So just to give you a little on the, you know, importance of, you know, learning French language, and I think more importantly, how would it help you if you have studied and in France and come to India? So I think we all know that India-France relationships have only strengthened over the last few years, and we do expect things to get even better going forward. And France is among the sixth largest economy. And we also know that today in India, we have 1,000 French companies that employ 3 lakh people. So I think the rest of the statistics are also very impressive. And, you know, the investment that France has in India and, you know, the India interest in France is also significant. And I think the next slide will give you an idea of the brands and their presence in India. So I think if you look at this screen, you will get an idea and familiarity that all these companies and logos that we, you know, you can see here are all the companies who have a presence in India. So, I mean, you can read them all. So I'm not going to kind of name them, but I think you can see that they are present across sectors, across industries. So a great opportunity for a lot of people coming from different areas and backgrounds to be able to get opportunities. Yes, you can go on to the next screen. So I'll just let you all know that Avni is already back with us, but I'm just going to finish this and let Avni come on, because there are a lot of questions relating to the schools, which, I mean, we would definitely like Avni to address. So this is, you know, the job opportunities that are available to you all. So like I said, we are very active in this area of assisting companies in getting the right talent and also helping, you know, be it students who studied in France, most certainly those who know the French language, and also those who may have nothing to do with France, but, you know, who have the technical expertise to be able to get employment with companies like this, because these are this is largely a client base. So, you know, the kind of jobs, I'm saying French language jobs, but I would like to say that, you know, except for the language translator jobs, these are the kind of jobs which would be available to students who've gone to France and, you know, studied and come from there, because practically all these other jobs, except for the first one, they do not really require the language. So, you know, where language becomes important, language definitely helps you to have that plus on your CV. It's a great soft skill to have. It's very good, especially when you're in France in terms of, you know, managing and getting around. But more importantly, when a company is hiring, and if somebody has studied in France or knows the French language, there is a very nice cultural fit which happens with the company. So that is where, you know, you would get an edge in terms of, you know, getting an opportunity with that company. So trade advisor, consultants, analysts, IT, food and beverage, supply chain, health, pharma, legal, I think we can name it all. So operate, you know, the profiles are across job functions. And again, there are across sectors, which you'll be able to see on the next slide. Yeah, so like I said, sectors, again, not really limited to anything. Great potential in hospitality, travel and tourism, constantly, in fact, banking and finance, legal consulting. I think the other area where we have seen a lot of demand is retail, e-commerce and trade. So those of you who are interested in, you know, doing a course in luxury, branding, digital marketing, those are also areas where there is a lot of potential. Again, demand in agro, food and beverage continues. Great demand for IT professionals, you know, who are experts and specialists who speak the language, who studied in France. Same goes for engineers, you know, who are constantly in demand, not only in France, but also in India. And I think great presence is also there, and, you know, demand in energy, oil and gas, a lot in the solar segment. So I think, as you would have gathered from the presentation, the potential is great. And considering that, you know, India and France are working closely together, and we see that, you know, relationship strengthening further, I think choosing France as a destination for study would definitely be a great idea. Yeah, Bhakti, you would like to go to the next slide? Yeah, so this is, you know, what does the chamber really do? So we have a quarterly newsletter, which we call Recruit Talon, which is sent out with masked CVs of students. So those of you who are interested in looking for job opportunities can reach out to us. Our contact details will be available on the next slide. And, you know, if you have a unique profile, we'd be happy to mask it and send it out to our database of 6,000 people who largely comprise of HR heads and CXO level management who are, you know, looking for talent. We conduct a lot of workshops and trainings. Recruitment, like I said, again, share your CV. We have a portal. You can upload your profile out there. We have a job fair, which is Bonjour Talents, which takes place once in 2 years. This year, we're going to skip it because of the current situation. And we do a lot of networking events for alumni, that is those students who have gone to France, studied, and come back. Next slide, Bhakti. And this is, you know, how you can connect with us. We have some groups on social media, Indo-French groups, which is on Facebook. It's a great platform with about 3,500 or 4,000 people already connected. We have our page on our website, which is available, which is the second block you can see. And the third is Indo-French Jobs Group, which is there on LinkedIn. So feel free to reach out to us on employment.service@ifki.org.in. This is for any job queries you may have. And of course, Avni is available. And if any questions do not get addressed today, feel free to reach out to us. And we'd be happy to connect you to Avni. So I'm not going to waste too much time because I know many of the students are very keen to hear the rest of the presentation. So Avni, over to you, and we'll just disconnect from my presentation. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sapna, and I'm really so sorry, like we had a sudden power cut. So, okay, I will continue with my presentation. I hope you can see my screen. Is it visible?
Not as yet, Avni. Not as yet. Yeah, that's fine.
Now, okay, thank you. So sorry. Okay, so we were discussing about the application process, like how the process works, and once you are admitted, like you will be having a conditional offer letter with a condition to pay the initial deposits, like initial tuition fee. And once you pay your initial tuition fees, you will be getting an unconditional offer letter along with the other necessary documents like fees receipt and accommodation letter if required and like that. So after you receive all the documents, the next step will be you have to prepare for your campus runs interview. So here I would like to say, like, all the students who are applying for your higher studies in France, you have to go through your interview at campus runs, which will be an academic interview. And you need to clear this interview. After clearing this interview, you will be getting a NOC from campus runs. And once you get a NOC, you can go and submit your documents at BFS. So campus runs, you know, it's a government body. And as I said, like you'll be having an academic interview over there. So before you go for your interview, you have to complete the process, online process of campus runs. So you have to create your account on campus runs website, and you will be getting your unique student ID, wherein you have to upload all your documents and everything. And once you are done with the process, once you have paid the campus runs fees, that is 16,500 INR online, then you need to schedule an appointment with campus runs manager. You need to drop an email like, you know, this is your student ID number, and you have secured admission in so-and-so program and so-and-so school. And once you get an interview date and time, you have to go at a particular date and time and finish off your interview. After getting NOC, as I said, like you can go and submit your document at VFS, Visa Application Center. But before that, you have to pay the VFS appointment fees, which is 99 euros. Of course, you don't need to pay the fees in euros. It will depend on the exchange rate of that particular date or a particular day where you are going for interview. So, but it is 99 euros, and it will depend on your exchange rate. Once you submit your documents, then you have to wait till your decision comes. In most of the cases, it takes like, you know, 15 to 20 working days, and sometimes it is even more, like it is 1 month also. But yes, majority of the cases you get your decision between 15 to 20 working days. And you will come to know, like, once you receive your passport back, or maybe you can go and collect at any of the VFS center, then and then only you can come to know, like, whether your visa application has been accepted or not. So you need to wait. It is not like a few other countries where you come to know immediately. Funds to be shown, like, you know, for your visa applications, how you can show the funds. So these are the things. Let me just give you an example. If you have been admitted in a particular program whose tuition fee is 15,000 euros, of which you have already paid 5,000 euros as your initial deposit. So now you are required to show the remaining tuition fees, that is 10,000 euros, plus the cost of living for one whole year. So this is how you need to show your funds, that is remaining tuition fees plus the cost of living. Now, if you are getting admission into one of the school located in Paris, the cost of living will be a bit on a higher side compared to other cities of France. So you need to show your funds accordingly. Coming to the next slide, like this is an expense format which is required as one of your visa document. You have to prepare this expense statement, wherein you have to mention, like, what are the tuition fees, of which what fees you have already paid, remaining tuition fees, and the cost of living, what you are showing, that I discussed already. And then you have to mention, like, who are your sponsors, sponsor one, two, and like that, and what are the sources of funds available. So what are the sources of funds you can show for your visa application? Mainly there are three sources of funds that you can show for your visa application. The one is, like, you know, you can show your savings account balance, which should be mandatory 3 months old. So of course you can show that. Secondly, if you are having any fixed deposits, you can show your funds through fixed deposits. Again, it should be 3 months old. And the third option, which is very common among the student, is you can apply for an education loan. So these are the three main methods how you can show your funds. And apart from this, we do require IT returns of last 3 years of your sponsors who are going to sponsor you. Now, let me just tell you, in France, at the most, two sponsors can sponsor you. And out of these two sponsors, one sponsor can be a third party who is not in blood relation with you. But yes, again, there is a condition over here, like if a third party is sponsoring you, then they are not allowed to show the funds more than, 30-40% of the total requirement. And the second sponsor, of course, it should be from your blood relation. Now, whosoever is sponsoring, as I said, we require their IT returns of last 3 years. We do require the financial affidavit on 100 rupees of stamp paper along with the other documents. Like if they are showing bank balance, then of course bank statements of last 6 months and fixed deposits and everything, fixed deposit certificate and all. So this is a format of affidavit. I will quickly go through it. So this we require on 100 rupees of stamp paper. Visa checklist, like what are the main documents you require to file your visa? And here you can see this is the checklist. Of course, I won't go through the entire checklist. It is available everywhere and you can also ask us. So because I think we will go to question and answer round once I finish off this quickly. Looking to the current scenario, there are certain benefits which schools have given to the students, and the very first is like pre-deposit, risk-free tuition deposits. Majority of the schools now they have tie-up with the institutions and banks wherein you can pay your fees online by credit card or debit card, and of course they have reduced their initial amount so that you can pay the fees by your debit or credit card. Application fees waived off, as I said, like now most of the schools they have waived off looking to the current scenario, pandemic scenario. Start online, this is what majority of the schools they have done for fall 2020 intake, like classes they have started online and then you can finish off your class on campus. New intakes, of course, they have been pushed back because of this pandemic situation. So these are the benefits that students they are getting right now from various universities. apart from that, I will quickly make you go through the activities that we have done in the past few months. And we have organized various webinars and with Embassy, with Campus France, of course, with IFKI. And we were having guest speakers from all these institutions. So we had a good amount of webinars which were conducted, and in which it were conducted on different topics. There you can see, like, this was our first webinar. After that, we had a webinar on Destination France. Then we had a webinar on France Initiative on International Education Post-COVID. Then we did had a webinar on Study in France, one of the most renowned education system in the world. We did a webinar for Study in France, Part 2, A Successful Career. So this were the few webinars. Apart from that, we did participated in ICF Dubai, which is one of the leading platform for all the schools and you know, the company like us. So we did had a stall over there, and of course we were part of ICF Berlin event as well. We have a network in 40 plus countries, so we recruit students not only from India, but we recruit students globally, and this is our network what we are having. If you have any questions, I will be mentioning our details over here. So if I am unable to answer all of your questions today, of course you can contact us at the email ID given over here, and this is the contact number where you can reach us and where we can solve your queries. So now I would like to open up the floor for a question and answer session, please.
Yes, hi, Avni. We do have some questions. I'll just read them to you and then you can answer them. Mr. Joel has asked, what are the options for medical education in France, and if they would be in English?
I'm so sorry for that, because, you know, only medical is one of the field that we are not having options in France. So I'm sorry for that.
Okay, the next question, Ms. Saksha has asked, is there any scope for studying clinical psychology in France?
As I said, like, you know, we don't have any clinical programs in France. So there are no such schools or universities who are providing these programs.
Okay. And then Mr. Siva Kumar has asked that he is an MBA with the 10 years of experience. If he has to do a PhD in France, will there be a stipend, and what exam does he have to qualify?
See, of course, you will be getting a stipend for doing your PhD program in France. And like, we have two very good schools who are offering PhD program. One is Rennes School of Business, which is again triple accredited. And we do have Schema Business School, who is also a very good accredited business school. So you can do your PhD in management with any of these two schools. And as I said, you will be getting a stipend from the government for doing your PhD. And it can be of 3 years or 5 years, depending upon the school which you are selecting.
Mr. Rajesh has asked that, could you name some schools or universities for fashion design related courses?
Yeah, like fashion programs, luxury management and fashion management we have in various schools, but for specialized one is Modart, which I mentioned. Apart from that, we have a luxury program in Rainbow, in Schema Business School, in American Business School, in EMLV School. So, and of course, there are a few other options as well, but these are 5 to 6 main schools who are offering programs in luxury brand management and, of course, in fashion industry. We do have a SPO's fashion school as well.
And Huda is asking, what are the options for somebody who has an experience of 10 years in radio? Some options in radio, I think.
Radio, FM, so are you, radio means, are you looking for communication management, or not sure about that? So can you please elaborate, like, whether you are looking for master programs in communication or like that?
Yes, she's looking for communication management. Yes.
You have if you're looking for master programs in communication, we have options with 3 to 4 schools. And as I said, like, we have options with Schema Business School, Rain School of Business, and American Business School. So these are the top 3 schools. Apart from that, we do have options in other business schools as well.
And Christopher is asking, this is related to the employment opportunities. So is there any remote work or freelance opportunities available in France?
Can you please come again? Actually, your voice was not clear.
Sorry. Are there any remote work or freelance opportunities available in France?
Along with your studies, like, of course, if you are looking for any options along with your studies, you can obviously do that. So there are good opportunities available there.
Okay, next question. If the visa is rejected, do they get the fee deposit back, the visa fee?
Yes, or the... very good question. Yeah. Please. Bhakti.
Sorry?
Bhakti,
If the visa is rejected, will they get the fee deposit back? That's the question.
Yes, of course, if your visa is rejected, you get your tuition fees back, and you get the entire amount what you have paid, you get the back. And of course, there will be somewhat deduction of bank charges. Apart from that, your entire tuition fees is refunded. It may take some time. Usually, it takes 30 to 45 working days to get your refund. But I will say that 100% you get your refund back.
Okay, next question. Is there an option to do a 1-year digital marketing program in any of the schools?
Yes. Yes, yes, you do have an option of doing 1-year digital marketing. So let me just specify over here. There are 2 kinds of master programs, wherein we have 50% of the programs that they are of 1 year, and the rest programs, they are of 18 months or maybe of 2 years. So 18 months program, in which you will be having 6 months of internships and 12 months of studies. And if there is a 2 years of master program, then you will be having internship of either 3 months in each year, or maybe internship of 6 months in your last year. And if you are going for your 1 year of master programs, then it will be 6 to 8 months of studies, and the rest 4 to 6 months will be your internship. This is how it works. But we do have an option of 1 year digital marketing program.
Okay, I'll go to the next question. What are some postgraduate program options for somebody who has B.Tech in computer science?
Okay, so as I mentioned, we work with very good engineering schools. So you have opportunities to do your, whether are you looking for master program or PhD program? You have already done post-graduation, or you are looking for your post-graduation?
No, post-graduation program is mentioned.
For post-graduation, of course, various fields in APITA Graduate School of Engineering, in ICEP, then we have also IPSA, then we have ESIP. So all these schools, they provide different programs like electronic and telecommunication, artificial intelligence, then of course, software engineering, and we do have aeronautical engineering. So these are the various options. We do have other specialization as well, but these are the few options that you do have for your master's in engineering.
Okay. Mr. Sivakumar is asking, could you please mention those schools that you mentioned for the PhD in management, the name of the B school?
Yeah, so it is Rains School of Business and Schema Business School.
Okay, next question. Is there any institute in the field of aviation?
Yeah, aviation, we do have programs at bachelor's as well as master's level. So we have programs in 2 schools. One is IPSA and one is Toulouse Business School. So we have aeronautical engineering programs and masters in aviation in Toulouse Business School as well. So these 2 schools, they provide programs in aviation.
Okay, now this is a question about documents. So Kritika is asking if her name is not on the birth certificate, or if the mother's surname is wrong, what is the procedure? Is there some way where they can still get admitted, or would there be a problem?
Yes, of course, there is a procedure. Like you can have an affidavit prepared. Okay, so and you can say that this is the change, and then you can submit your document. So you need to have an affidavit for that.
But ma'am, if my document doesn't have my name only, then what should I do?
In that case, first you have to get your name on your birth certificate, because see, birth certificate, it is not mandatory for getting an admission or getting a visa. It is nowhere mandatory. But birth certificate you will be requiring for getting the CAF benefit, that is accommodation benefit. Okay, so you require a birth certificate at that time. So once you are gone through all the procedure, once you are in France as well, that's fine. You can get that modified certificate later on. I know, of course, it is a lengthy process to get your name on the certificate and all. But if at all your name is not mentioned only, then of course you need to get your name on the certificate first.
Can it not be rectified with an affidavit?
No, affidavit is applicable where your name is wrongly mentioned. Okay, so it will be applicable in that. But if at all your name is not there only in affidavit, then on birth certificate, then affidavit won't work, because you need to have your name.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, welcome.
Okay, this is the next question. What's the scope for cosmetic science in France, and are there any public universities that offer this course?
Regarding public university, I'm not sure, because we are not into the public university tie-up. We only promote private schools and universities, and of which, like, none of the schools, they are having this program. So I'm sorry for that. And public universities, I'm not aware if they might be having this program or not.
Can you suggest any school for supply chain specialization program?
Yes, there are various schools who are offering supply chain specialization, and of which few schools again are Brain School of Business, Schema Business School, Cash Business School, Neoma Business School, Toulouse Business School, American Business School. So these are very good schools. And of course, apart from that, we do have other 5 to 6 schools who are offering this program.
Okay, next question. Is there any opportunity for masters in aeronautical field?
Yes, as I mentioned, like, we have masters in aeronautical engineering or aeronautical aviation management in 2 schools. And one is IPSA and the other is Toulouse Business School. So these are the 2 schools who are giving this program.
Okay, the next question, that you mentioned that not in all courses one can get a 2 years of job search visa. So is there a way to get it extended then?
See, if your course is not RNCP certified, then you won't be getting 2 years of stay back option. But of course, you will be having 1 year of stay back option. So each and every program, whether it is a bachelor program, master programs, definitely you are having a 1 year of stay back. And if your program is RNCP certified, you will be having 2 years of stay back. So what I will say, if you are looking for 2 years of stay back, before applying, please confirm that whether your program is RNCP certified or not. And now majority of the schools, majority of the programs, they are RNCP certified, so that you will be getting 2 years of stay back. But if not 2 years, definitely you are getting 1 year of stay back after your studies.
Okay, next question. Somebody said that they speak A1 level French. So should they mention that in their cover letter, or should they first clear an examination and attach that certification?
See, it will be always better, you attach the certificate, A1 level of French. And of course, you can mention in your resume, know the A1 level of French. But for the documentation part, it is good if you attach your certificate also.
Okay, I think this is the last question. Any specific reason why you do not have any private for public university course?
Sorry, can you please come back again?
Yes. Any specific reason why you do not have any ties with any public university courses?
No, there is no specific reason. But as I said, now we have started expanding, and we are also, looking for tie-up with public universities. But of course, if you are interested to secure your admission in public universities, we can assist you for the same. We do know the procedure and everything, so definitely we can assist you for that.
Okay, we have one more question. Anupama is asking, she has completed her bachelor's and master's degree and would like to do an advanced master's program. And she's interested in studying in English. So is it possible to join the second year of master's program, that is the M2?
Okay, so, of course, looking to your documents and, after the Skype interview, school will be deciding whether you will be eligible to get admission directly into second year or not. So what modules you have already studied, what is the curriculum you have already studied, all this will be evaluated. And also on the basis of your Skype interview, it will be decided whether you will be getting admission into second year or not. Of course, many of our students, they have received admission directly into second year, so you can be eligible for that. But these are the criteria which need to be fulfilled before you get admitted directly into your second year.
Next question. Any reason why you don't have any courses in the medical field? So,
actually, France itself, in my 12 years of experience, I haven't come across any of the private schools or universities that are providing the medical courses. Of course, for public universities, I'm not aware, but I'm 90% sure, even in public universities also, they don't offer this program. So I don't know, what is a specific reason why they don't have this program. But yes, private universities, they don't have this. I'm sure about that.
Next question. Could you name a few good schools for digital marketing?
Courses in digital marketing. Again, digital marketing, as I mentioned, the 5-6 schools for the programs before also, they do have this, Rain School of Business, Schema Business School, then American Business School. Of course, we have in Neoma Business School. So these are the few schools who are offering specialization in digital marketing as well.
Okay, next question. What kind of accommodation proof is expected?
For your visa, then I will say previously they were asking for accommodation proof of a minimum of 3 months. But now the rule has been changed because of the pandemic. And I don't know till what time it will be the same rule. But yes, nowadays, 15 to 20 days accommodation is also accepted for your visa. And this can be of any, accommodation booking partners like Booking.com or Airbnb, or you can have 15 to 20 days of actual accommodation. But yes, you need to make sure that you have an actual one. It will be of 15 to 20 days. It is accepted for spring 2021 as well. But for fall 2021, I'm not sure whether rule is going to change or not. Previously, for 3 months, again, it can be the same. But right now, this is the rule, 15 to 20 days of actual accommodation is required.
Okay, I'm going to the next question. Somebody said they came across a course for strategic management in Toulouse Business School, but it was taught in French and English. So is there any school that teaches this course only in English?
Yes, only in English. You can refer Rain School of Business, Schema Business School, also Neoma Business School. So these three schools, they provide this program 100% in English.
Okay, next question. In the courses that are taught in both English and French, what level of French does one person need to know?
Yeah, you require a B2 level of French for the programs that are taught in French and English as well, because you should be not only able to communicate in French, but you should also know how to write in French. So you'll be requiring B2 level of French for this.
Do you help in finding accommodation?
As I said, like, we do have our registered office in France, and there are certain accommodation partners with whom we can link you up, and we can assist you like this for finding an accommodation.
Do you know, can you speak a little bit more on the sponsorship program? What are the cutoffs, etc.?
Sponsorship program. So are you asking about the scholarships or the fund sponsorship?
Scholarship, yes. She said
about scholarship. Okay, so scholarship, as I mentioned, like, you know, there are scholarships given by schools and universities which will be based on merit, which will be early bird scholarships. So if it is a early bird scholarship, like, you know, you will be given a deadline, particular deadline to pay the fees. If you are you will be said, like, you are required to pay the fees within 15 days once you are admitted. And if you are paying fees within 15 days, that is your initial deposit. And you might be getting 10% or maybe 15-20% of early bird discounts. So like this, your tuition fees will be reduced. Regarding merit-based scholarships, all schools, they have different criterias, but of course they have, like, Rain School of Business, they are giving maximum scholarships up to 4,000 euros as your merit, or depending on your merit. And even in SCEMA, you get scholarships up to 1,500, 2,000 euros, again, depending on your merit as well as on your Skype interview. So it will be decided, like, whether you are eligible or not on the basis not only of your academics, what you have studied till now, but also how you are performing in your Skype interview. So this is how your merit-based scholarship is decided. And of course, for government scholarships, as I said, like, if you are planning for spring intake and you want to apply for government scholarships, then you need to hurry up, because the deadlines are pretty soon. And for fall, of course, you have plenty of time. And in government scholarship also, like, we have Chapak scholarship, in which you are getting certain amount of scholarship for your tuition fees and also towards your living expense. And also there are different criterias and different amounts that you are getting for scholarships.
Next question. Can we submit our visa application in any state, or it has to be in the one mentioned in our passport?
See, it depends. Like, if you are from Gujarat region, and but you your passport is of Gujarat region, but now since last 5 to 6 years, if you are working somewhere in south, like if you are working in Bangalore or Chennai, then it is okay for you to go and submit your application in Bangalore or in Chennai, wherever you are based since last 5 years. Of course, you need to show the proof, like you are working over here, and this are the salary slips, and this is the accommodation where you are living and all. Then you can submit your application over there, though your passport is of Gujarat region. So this is how it works.
But most of us have gone back to our homes now, and our passport is of the state that we were working in. Would that work in this case as well?
Yes, of course, you can request to our Campus France during your interview, like, you would like to apply to a particular VFS and you would like to submit your documents. So they will be accepting the applications because of the current scenario. Many of our students, they have faced this for fall 2020 intake, and they have submitted their applications also in other states apart from where they were living, or apart from there where they were having their passports. So in this situation right now where we are into, you can of course submit your applications, but yes, a request has to be put forward to Campus France during the interview.
Okay, thank you.
Next question. How much processing fee do you charge for assistance in application in different universities?
We don't charge any processing fees. there is no charge for our services.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, sure.
I found a course in which I was getting two, generally people are getting 2 degrees, one from Grand Ecole and one is state recognized degree. But since I have done only 3 years of UG, I'm not eligible for a state recognized degree. How does that affect my job prospects?
It totally does not affect your job prospects, because as I mentioned, like, you know, whatever degree you are getting and whatever studies you are doing in France, it is valid worldwide. As I mentioned, like, you know, internships you can do in any part of the world. So it really doesn't matter, like, you know, whether you are getting a Grand Ecole degree or whether you are getting state, of course, state accredited degree, if you are getting, that is well and good. But then what you can do, you know, after your 1 year of master's, then if you are completing your first year of master's in France, you can go for another year, and then most probably you will be eligible for getting a, you know, state recognized degree as well. But yes, it really doesn't matter a lot, because internships you can do anywhere, any part of the world.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Are there any more questions? I think there are no more questions. So I'll just pass it on to my colleague Sapna Verma to do the water thing.
Thank you so much, Bhakti. So a big thank you to Avni and to Join In Campus for taking out time and really taking us through this wonderful presentation. Avni, I must add that I think you've shared great insights, very crisp presentation, and really, really happy to see this interaction from our participants. So I do see there are a lot of questions being asked, and feel free to reach out. Avni has shared her coordinates. Feel free to reach out to us, and we'd be again happy to, you know, reconnect you with Avni. Yeah, it's right up there on the screen. And I think, you know, because we are also the French Chamber of Commerce, and we work so closely with students and, you know, job opportunities and study in France as well. I think it's a great choice in terms of destination, France, that you're looking at. And there's a wide array, you know, looking at the private schools which are there in terms of what they are really offering, the courses, the support that is there. So a lot of plus points, I think Avni highlighted, in terms of costing, in terms of, you know, the government being able to supply benefits, you know, in terms of not only in terms of the visa, I think, which is there. I don't know, Avni, no one really asked you that, but I think there is an APS visa, right, where you can continue to work, you know, stay in France and take up some jobs within certain parameters for another 2 years. Then there is accommodation assistance which is given to you. So there are a lot of pluses which are there. It's definitely a good choice, or rather I'd say for those who are exploring, definitely worth it. So maybe y'all can actually get in touch with Avni directly, and you can even discuss one-on-one to be able to understand, based on your profile, which would be the best course, which would be the best school. And of course, once you all have come back from France, or if you're looking for any jobs over here, we are happy to support you, so that you know, to make that experience of yours worthwhile. So Avni, once again, thank you so much. A big thank you to all our participants. We are really, really happy to support you. Feel free to reach out to us, and we'd really be happy to play a very important role in helping you shape your careers. So thank you so much. We'll end the meeting here today, and we'll be happy to connect soon on another occasion. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.